Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. For today's video I have something very special for you prepared. I am so excited to finally show you what I am planning to build in the basement of my house. It is not like a really big stuff, but I think it's the beginning of something and I always had this kind of dream. So stay tuned in the video if you want to know more about this home lab that I am preparing for you. So, what I'm planning here is in the basement of my house, at least in one of the rooms of the basement of the house in which I am living now, I am planning to build like a small home lab. It's not like a home lab to put a server or to put video cameras or something. It's like a really workplace for me. It's not going to be like a huge workshop or something like that. It's going to be more like a place in which I can work and do a lot of things that I really have plans to do in the future for my research and for the research in general, and just to make more videos for you. And the plan is to build like in this room that I'm going to show you right now, a basic lab with some workstations, some very basic monitors and a lot of hardware and things that I just had laying around and that I just accumulated with the years. Other things I bought, but I really try to keep this basement renovation as clean as I could and not really spending a lot of money, because I think it's not the idea to spend a lot of money to make a huge renovation. I think it's more like a start with something small, and then if you need to take a look how it's working, how it is working for you, if you feel comfortable doing some things in your basement. And maybe after that you can allow yourself to invest a little bit more of money. But for today's video I'm just going to show you how is my plan is supposed to be, and just to show you that things can really become true if you really want. And maybe there is a lot of people that do not believe you sometimes that you want to do something, but it's just about your motivation and it's about you believing in yourself. And I think that's a very nice video. It's something very different. But this is the start of something. This is a new project that I had honestly since years. I had this idea of build a research lab at my place, and this is the start of sort of this project, of this kind of dream that I have. And I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you like it, and see you now. So hello, I'm back here. So I want to tell you as well something. The only thing I invest a little bit of money, and not for this basement, so it was for myself, and in order to make all the different things as well. I think to have a good camera is a nice thing. So I bought a new camera. This is the Canon 250D. It's something as well not very expensive. It's around $500 or something like that. And I already had a few equipment for my cameras before, so I think this is a very nice investment. I hope you like the quality as well. I will do as well my best to produce better videos. And yeah, so let's start. So this is the basement. It is about probably maybe 20 square meters. I guess. So it is, I clean as better as I could. It is still not finished, guys, so just have patience. This is a long project probably, and it's going to be to take a few videos. I hope you stay in the videos if you like them. So these things, they need to go. Those things we need to manage somehow, how do we storage, because this is still important. So far this place here is clean already, and this is like the only thing that I already kind of built. This is going to be like the main working desktop, the working desk, and I have plants like some here in the middle, because I have one lamp here, and that's another nice lamp actually, and then I have this another lamp here, something here in the middle, like a small table as well, in which I can record videos, maybe make some recordings from above. And then here is just as well things, and this is another shelf that is part of the house, is part of the house, and we have different things there. So I still cannot clean that, and I think it's going to stay probably, but at least is the shelves are pretty nice actually. Maybe in the future they can have a very good function. So for today, as I said, my main workplace is going to be upstairs where I live. And there I have my main workstation, there I have my main monitor, and that's the most powerful computer that I have, in which I produce most of my research, and I do most of my things. I do play games and everything. But for this basement lab, I have two workstations. I have two HPC 440. They are actually, the CPU is very powerful, I will say. I have two of them. This is my second one. And actually I need this for later, and this is like two HPC 440. Each of them has 18 cores, and these are the Xeon E5-2699B3. But the graphics card, I still don't have really good graphics card for them. I am planning to buy something very basic of Quadro, maybe like a Quadro K2000 or something like that for each of these computers. And they have, I think they have only 8 GB of RAM. I think I will upgrade it maybe probably to 64 GB each computer. Probably they are very cheap. They use ECC 2133 MHz. And yeah, I don't need to really equip very intense or very heavy these both computers, because I'm going to use them only to print some stuff or maybe basic stuff, but not really to do my job. As I said, my main workstation is upstairs. And then I still as well didn't want to invest in monitors, because yeah, I think, as I said in the beginning, you do not need to invest in nice things. I think it's important to know if everything is going to work out. I have two old TVs, really old, maybe 19, 20 inches TVs, and they are full HD, but they work, and I think they do good for just to make running the small lab. I have a 3D printer here. This is from Anycubic. Anycubic Mega X. This is the biggest version that they have. And I have for today probably, or in another video, I have some very basic SSDs for the workstations. I think some very basic stuff. I have another space compact mouse, space mouse compact from 3D Connection. This is the cable edition, with the one with cable. And in my workstation upstairs, I have the one that is wireless. And I have as well
an NVIDIA Tesla K40. This is the one that I was in, that it was installed in my workstation. I have some old keyboards, LAN cables, old mouses. I have a Fritzbox router and some Hue LEDs that probably is going to look very nice, I guess, in the future. And yeah, that's the plan for today. Install the solid state drive in both computers. I'm going to install, I think I'm going to go with Ubuntu. With Ubuntu 20.04, I guess. And yeah, both are going to have Ubuntu. I'm not going to use Windows for this basement. My main computer has Windows 10 Pro, but not these ones. I want to do as well some things with Linux, so I think this is the best option. And that's the plan for today. Install the solid state drives in both workstations. Install Linux. Build the... I think I can put one of these TVs in the monitor arm that I have here. I think it should work. Ah, shame, I forgot to bring my microphone. I will bring it later. This is for my microphone as well. I'm probably going to use it later. And that's pretty much for today. Just very basic, build computers and make sure that everything is working here. And yeah, that's all for today. So see you now. So we need to disassemble this. I have no idea how. Probably just a few screws here. Yep, and that's all. This one and this one. So that's it for the first TV, for the first monitor. I will say, is as I said, the monitor is an old TV. This is a very old monitor arm that I bought as well, like maybe 2 years ago for 30 euros. It's not the best. If you can see, I forgot to mention, this is the Linmon from IKEA. This is 2 meters by 60 centimeters, and it costs like around, I don't know, 20 euros. Maybe 30 US dollars, 20 euros, something like this. These are well from IKEA. They are like 15 euros each. They are very cheap. I have them like since years as well for like this one. I paid as well in eBay like 15 euros, something like that. This is the typical IKEA lamp for as well like 10 euros, I guess is the price. So really guys, believe me, you don't need to buy the most expensive things for things that not really have a real function for now in your space. Yeah, so that's one very important thing. So that's at least one computer. Let me plug it in and then let's start with the Ubuntu installation. Let's see if this works, because I think I paid as well like 17 euros, maybe like 20 US dollars for this solid state drive. It is from the MA brand NetApp. As I say, you don't need to buy expensive stuff. And depending for what you need the machines, but for example, this machine, I only wanted to visualize maybe some files before printing, or maybe to watch some videos, to watch some tutorials, to make small editions of 3D models. And I really don't need that much power. I will do install as well a 1 terabyte hard drive in the computer. So this is going to be only for the operating system. And Linux, if you know maybe a little bit of Linux, of Unix-based systems, if you have 120 gigabytes, you are going to have almost like really literally 120 gigabytes free to use. Not like Windows. Like Windows, if you have a 120 gigabytes hard disk or solid state drive, is going to give you maybe like 100 gigabytes usable. So Linux is better, just keep that in mind.
So now we're done with the Ubuntu installation. It was actually pretty simple. You just need to insert the USB stick. I always do create USB bootable with software that is called Rufus. Amazing software. In few seconds you can have your Linux installation bootable for a USB. Yeah, so now it's done. As I said, it was pretty simple. Now you can see in it's Ubuntu. I have 4 GB of RAM. I have the 18 core, 36 threads, Xeon 2699 B3, as I said. I have a really old AMD graphics card. I will replace the graphics card, as I said, for a Quadro K2000 or maybe it's a Fire Pro W2100. They are like 30-40 euros each. And I don't really care about the graphics card here, as I said. And memory RAM, I need to upgrade the memory RAM. I think I will be installing 64 gigs of RAM in each of the computers. So yeah, that's the first step. So now it's one computer. The solid state drive is working perfectly. The 1 TB hard drive is also already installed. So I have a little bit of storage if I want to store something big. And that's pretty much done for the first computer. I have pretty basic HP. This is the original HP from my other workstation. And I have a pretty basic Logitech mouse here. So nothing fancy, just to work here. And that's all for the first computer. Let's go now prepare. Actually, I don't know where I'm going to prepare the second setup. Let's see how do we build the second computer. So I was a little bit worried about how to get internet to the basement because there is no Ethernet connection, there is no internet here. And my router is in the 3rd floor. This house has the basement, 1st floor, 2nd floor, 3rd floor. And we are like a complete family here, and each part of the family lives in a different floor. So every house, every apartment has his own independent entrance, and my apartment is just in the top. And there is no way to get internet here. There is no way to get some cables here. So I was a little bit worried, but not really that much, because here in the basement I wanted to have something not offline, but not really high speed internet or something, because I just want to have, I want to have the 3D printer. I want to have it offline for security reasons and just to print something in there. And maybe later in the future, my plan is to get some robots here, and I also want to have the robots offline at least, or online, but only here in the local network, not in the internet. So I was not really worried, but do you remember the fridge book that I showed you before? So I found a very nice solution for this. So this is the fridge box. I just happened to mesh everything together because I have a fridge box in the 2nd floor, and then I have the fridge box in my 3rd floor, and I just put this here. I'm going to fix it later better to the walls here, but everything is in a mesh connected, and it is getting the I'm getting a stable connection. Maybe it's not the fast connection, but it's very stable. And I am getting like, I think like 2.3 megabytes per second or something like that. And I'm pretty happy to be honest with that, 2.3 megabytes per second. I am more than happy with that. And yeah, at least you can watch some YouTube videos, or I don't know, you can do a little bit of stuff. So guys, this is how is it going. There is no the best electrical installation here, but I think it's okay, it's good. And I'm not going to be pushing this computer like 100% or something like that. So I think it will be fine, pretty much I'm fine. So I just installed one, I don't know the name in English, this is like a multiple connector or something like this. And then this is, I decided to run this computer on Windows 10 Pro. And this computer is already running Ubuntu 20.04. Why? Because maybe one day or something I do need to do with Windows or software in Windows, like all the CAD software is only available in Windows. Maybe one day I need to do something with this. So I think it's nice to have both systems here. I decided at the end. Another monitor arm as well, like 20 euros monitor arm I just ordered it, so it's going to be here. And then I'm going to remove my microphone here, probably this I don't need it anymore. And then I'm going to put this old TV as well in a monitor arm to free the space here. And I just noticed that probably I need to
install another leg here because I think it's a little bit is bending already a little bit because it's already old, as I said, and that's how it's looking now. I think it's looking pretty good, and the new table and everything is going to arrive on Saturday, and it's going to be here probably in the middle, or maybe I'm going to clean this place and it's going to be here, and then I'm going to install the 3D printer over here probably, or yeah, something like that. And then we need to clean that stuff as well. All my tools, I'm going to accommodate them somewhere here, I guess. I still need to find a place for these things. Yeah, that's how it's going now. I think it's looking pretty good. Yeah, the internet is working amazing, I need to say. And that's how it's going. Now it's starting. So yeah.
So now it's done. At least it's done for today. As I said, today it was the objective to keep it pretty simple. Linux is now installed in this computer. Windows is now installed in this computer as well. And I think that's pretty much for today. As I said, I just ordered a new monitor arm for this computer, and I think that's going to be it for now. The 3D printer, I still need to get delivered the table and the legs for the table, and then it's going to be maybe in the other side, as I told you, and that is going to be the 3D printer. And yeah, I think that's for today. I already wired some cables here for the network. Let me show you. So this is a network cable. It's going back to my router that I was there. This guy is running over Wi-Fi. I still need to get another cheap keyboard. I'm missing one. This is pretty old. I think I bought this mouse like 4 years ago, like 13 euros or something. It's still working. I just need to get another keyboard, another monitor arm, upgrade the memory RAM of these two computers, and I think that's going to be for at least for now. As I said, my main research, my main computer stuff that I do it over it. Upstairs at my main computer, as I told you a few times already, is the HPC 840. That computer is equipped with the best that I could get for that computer, and that's where I do my main job. And the objective, as I said, from here is to have a different place in which I can get equipment later. My objective is to get a Prusa 3D printer, maybe in the future a universal robot here as well. And I have a lot of things planned to do with those things. And I'm gonna try to do some tests with new filaments to keep the soft robotics research going on as well here at my place. So yeah, stay tuned if you want to keep the newest status of this home lab, and see you until the next time.